Hey everyone, it's Meg, and welcome back to another reaction episode to Batman the Animated Series. We are on episode 41, I'm pretty sure, and it is called If You're So Rich. Nope. If You're So Smart, Why Aren't You Rich? Which is funny. That title did not register until I just read it out loud, because if that is a question being directed to Batman, he's very rich. We'll see. But I've heard very good things about this episode. It was one that was recommended to edit for YouTube. So I'm really looking forward to this. And as always, I'm just super excited to sit down and watch a cartoon with you guys. Best job in the world. But yeah, let's go ahead and get started. I hope you're having good days and nights. Christmas with the Joker. Christmas with Meg. Same thing. I am the Joker. Oh, is this going to be the Riddler? Enigma?
Has Edward Enigma come in yet?
I knew it! Cubicles.
Where's my office? My door was right here.
What?
You're out of here. You're history. You're fired. Comprende?
Comprende?
I created the riddle of the Minotaur game. This company is making millions from my genius.
Oh.
Success didn't come from the product, Nigma. Competitron is the corporate attitude. Its strength is in the boardroom, the deal, the contract.
Yuck. This would turn me into a villain.
Your amoral greed is no match for an intellect like mine.
If you're so smart, why aren't you rich?
Okay, suddenly I am a Riddler stan.
You can stop pitching, Mockridge. I want this deal. This city desperately needs the jobs it'll create.
Aww.
Well, whatever that meant, it sure rattled his cage.
Why do multi-million dollar deals break down in the wasteland?
Oh, I love that transition between his voice, Bruce's and Batman's voice.
It has to have a double meaning.
Master Dick, that must be quite a computer game. Not a game, Alfred. The game. Riddle of the Minotaur.
Ooh! You lose.
My word.
Doesn't Mockridge own a club downtown called the Wasteland?
The Wasteland? Oh. It's a dead end, see?
Oh.
Come on. Daniel Mockridge is walking into a trap.
He doesn't want to do his job. He wants to just play his video game. I love that Bruce lets Robin slash Dick play computer games on the back computer. That's so iconic. Oh, he knows it's Nigma.
Decode that message all by yourself, Mockridge?
You're trespassing, Nigma. You can't kill this deal. I'm selling out to Wayne, and there's nothing you can do to stop me.
You don't understand. I have a proposition for you. Solve it. Then we'll talk.
Hey, I thought you were rich, so why aren't you smart?
What is this? Some kind of extortion scheme?
You think I want money? Not anymore. What I want now is you.
And truth be told, he just wanted his credit. He just wanted credit for thinking of that software. I don't think he wanted money from the beginning.
Well, well, bat something or other, isn't it? Who invited you?
Oh my God, those shoes.
With the Riddler.
Yes. It's green and purple. It's like a green and a lavender.
Riddler. What is that, Nigma? Some kind of joke on your name?
My, my. Can we actually have a brain beneath that pointy cowl of ours?
Mm-hmm.
Have you brawn to match?
Oh, kicked his butthole. Robin. Wow, beautiful scenery. Nice.
Let's consider you handled for now, shall we?
Oh, yeah. If you want to get out, then you have to figure out the puzzle. Robin. He's having so much fun.
Well done, Batman. But have you wits enough to save two people at the same time?
It's my own variation on the Chinese finger puzzle.
Batman, you gotta help me. I can pay you, Batman.
No.
Anything you want.
Hey, it's getting hot in here. Get me out of this thing.
Oh, no. I know the Chinese finger puzzle. I actually do know that.
I figured the creator of the Minotaur game was behind this the minute I saw that billboard.
Are you fangirling?
The company records I examined.
Oh.
Edward Nigma.
I get it. Enigma, meaning a puzzle or riddle. An enigma. At least we know who we're looking for. Lights. Why are they all flashing?
It's Morse code.
He's such a puzzly puzzle guy. I bet he's happy to find his match. Because Batman's very clever. He's
Batman
so sassy.
Batman knows who I am.
Uh-huh.
We'll have to put him and his snot-nosed cohort out of the way first.
Snot-nosed.
When is the Minotaur's owner as high as an elephant's hide?
Well, Mockridge owns the Minotaur, but what's as high as an elephant's eye?
Corn.
What? I don't understand that one. That would be awful.
From an old song lyric.
Oh!
What's another word meaning corn?
A kernel, a cob?
Maze. When Mockridge is in the maze.
Nice!
The maze at the amusement park.
Exactly.
This is more like the Riddler I know.
Him at exactly 4:30
he loves special effects.
Which gives you less than 10 minutes to run the maze and find him.
It's 4 a.m.?
Throw down your utility belts. It'll be more interesting that way, don't you think?
They're like, okay, sure. This sounds fun. This guy might die, but, you know, it'll be fun.
You'll have to answer the riddle of the Minotaur, too.
I can't wait. How far did you say you got in the game?
No, I'm not sure. Maybe halfway?
Already I love this.
Oh.
Oh, the griffin. Well, that just blocks off the way you came, that's all.
Oh, my God. I want to do this without the pain. Oh, it reminds me of Harry Potter, Goblet of Fire. That maze at the end. Loser's head.
Loser's ahead?
Stop!
Loser's ahead.
Oh.
I don't know what's worse, the traps or the puns.
You love the puns.
I guess this isn't a good time to tell you. Nobody's ever made it to the center of the maze.
Oh. Uh-oh. You guys got this. You got this. You're very smart.
You have 8 minutes, gentlemen.
That was
then
only 2 minutes?
Becomes the only good corporate shark. A dead one.
Bro's anti-capitalism. How can I dislike him?
Because here comes the hand of fate!
This is so cool and it looks so fun.
But in the Arab world, you always eat with your right hand.
Nice! That's so cool. I didn't know that.
Look out!
Not the blades. Oh, shit.
It's a musical puzzle. The key of D has 2 sharps. The key of A has 3.
Oh. But
the key of C has no sharps.
You guys know your music literacy.
1 minute, Batman.
Oh, nice.
You're not allowed to tamper with the hand of fate.
I don't believe in fate.
Yeah!
But you'll still have to answer the riddle.
I have billions of eyes. Yet I live in darkness. What am I?
That's simple. The human brain.
Nice. My brain did not come up with that.
It's the only thing Edward Nigma respects.
Mm.
Destroy them!
That's not fair, Riddler.
How do you take out a Minotaur with a single blow? Like this!
That's not a riddle. Not a riddle.
I'm not even in the amusement park, and by the time you get out of the maze, I'll be out of the city.
But you'll be back, huh? Kind of iconic. Yep. He's living in fear. Oh, poor guy.
How much is good night's sleep worth?
It's worth
now
a lot.
There's a riddle for you.
Oh, and you know those eyes remind me of the eyes when the Riddler was like half, not half, but he was in shadow and you could just see like the bulbs of his eye. And it was really creepy. And that's what that reminded me of. I loved that. That was one of my favorite episodes I have never been a Riddler fan because I've mostly... Well, I know him through Batman 2022 with Robert Pattinson. Then I know him with the Arkham games. And in the Arkham games, especially with Arkham Knight, you know, he has this kind of greasy look. He has these goggles. He does a lot of the Batmobile puzzles. So he has like grease on him. And it makes sense. You know, he's in this tank top and kind of not a flannel, but like a button down. And he looks kind of greasy. And it's so cool to see the Riddler as this sophisticated, smart puzzle appreciator. Up until now, I just thought the Riddler was pretty self-centered and kind of like a, well, actually, man who would like mansplain things. But this gave me a new appreciation for his character because he's actually quite spiffy in this. He's got some dazzling green shoes. He's in a suit, a beautiful emerald green suit. And I understand why they want to kind of create a modern Riddler. And that's why, you know, the Ave Maria version. I don't think it's worse necessarily. I don't know enough about Batman to say like that's not a good adaptation, because I do. Part of what I liked about Matt Reeves' Batman was just it felt like our version, our generation's version. But again, similar to the Joker, like I loved his outfit. I loved his walk, his sass. And then don't even get me started on the whole moral that money cannot buy everything. And so his origin story is about, I don't know if it's true for the comics and other things, but I hadn't even heard his origin story unless I missed it in the Arkham games. But that his idea was basically stolen. And the, like, if you're so smart, why aren't you rich? I feel like a lot of Americans especially can just relate to that. It's like your smarts and your creativity will only get you so far. And rich people will kind of steal your ideas out from under you and profit. And being smart does not equal being rich. But as Batman said, and I love that these episodes can put a little bow, they can tie a little bow at the end, and you can feel hopeful because Batman's like, well, how much is a good night's sleep worth? And if you've ever suffered from insomnia, if you've ever struggled with sleep, you know it's worth the world. And there are quite a few things that money cannot buy. So I loved that. And I hope that he shows up in future episodes. Kind of crazy it took, you know, 40 plus episodes. I do like that there are quite a few similarities, though, with what I've seen in the games and stuff, because he loves the projections. He loves like a good IRL puzzle. And in the games, he loves his videos and live streams and projections and stuff. And he does cheat. He throws little temper tantrums because Batman is on his level. He has met his match with Batman. And so he will get frustrated and just be like, no, well, you didn't win because beep, beep, beep. He does have a little insecurity, big ego. And I like that because, you know, these villains have to be likable and then they have to be annoying. And I've always found him annoying. So, but I really liked this version. Thank you so much to all my patrons. If you're watching this on the unedited watch along, thank you. If you would like to join the Patreon, that will be available to you down below. Thank you for continuing this journey with me, and I will see y'all next time. Love you so much. Bye.